Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Linn & Associates with your metals market update for this Thursday, the 12th of July, 2018, in the time, well, we're just after 3:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. That's why you're not seeing any quotes right now in the stock indices. They'll reopen at 3:30 for the remaining 30 minutes of the day. But we did see a day turn to green in most metal markets, even with the dollar index basically steady to slightly higher. Was it that the market overdid the monster washout in commodities yesterday? Probably to a degree. We haven't seen any breakthrough yet with China, although I was reading that the top Chinese people would like to say, and they're trying to tone things down between the president. I saw a number of analysts say that the president's $200 billion in tariffs will likely not go into place if China sits down and talks with the U.S. and makes movement on intellectual property. If they don't do that, things aren't going to happen. They're already talking the impact on the average American. I was on with Liz Claman on Fox Business a couple hours ago. And basically, they were pointing out that pre the Chinese tariffs, it's running the average American about $62 a month. After the Chinese tariffs, if they go in, not a month, a year, and then it'll be about $120 per person or more, because we import so much of our goods from China. We have so many things made. Go in your home, look at how many things are made from China. It's surprising, but we'll see what happens. Right now, Steve Mnuchin doesn't think we're in a trade war. We're in a trade dispute. I differ. Mohammed El Arian says we're in a trade dispute, not a trade war. I looked it up in Google. It seems to meet what is a trade war, but these guys are bright. I'll go by them. In the gold weekly chart, what I see is a market that has gone from 1353, now it's at 1247. And for the week, and that's what this chart is, we're down $8 for the week. So it's not a dramatic decline. It's still a decline, but a slowing one. That's the way to look at it. When you see the bar chart, and this is the August gold, you see how you bounced, you came back down. Are you going to get back to these old lows or not? I guarantee you that's what some of the gold traders are looking for. I started looking also into the month of August, what starts happening on a seasonal basis, and we do start late July. We begin a move that often, now let me just use the word, often you see the gold rally. Remember, those years didn't have tariff wars. Those years didn't have a dollar that's this strong. Those type of years maybe didn't have a stock market fighting with it, and it didn't have a Fed in recent years that is on a progress of tightening. So you got to take all that into account. Are we trending? The answer is a flat no. If you define a trend as and a downtrend, lower highs, lower lows, you don't have that. You have a higher high and a lower low. That is not a trend. That doesn't mean the bias of the market isn't down. It is down because prices are under the 18-day average of closes. And I use the 18-day average of closes as a line in the sand. It's a filter for many of the technical studies I look at. When the market is under that price, if my other studies are getting bearish, they're clicking in like a checklist. And you look at that. Get over that number, and I no longer am looking at the short side of the market. I'm getting a friendly bias. Stay on the number, that's it. And here's another part. When you're under and you rally, I call it the line in the sand because it often acts as a resistance point. You're under it. It's a number that the market will go around. Go look at what cocoa is doing in my agriculture video, and you get a feel for what this gold market was doing right here. The Bollinger Bands would have been narrowed in there, and you see it right through here, and then eventually out of it, and while it worked out to the downside, it could be to an upside move. But it's from that sideways action things develop. Well, right now, you're at a pattern where because you're trading, and you can see what I'm holding my hand here, sideways, you're bringing in the Bollinger Bands again. And that's a process the market has to go through. Right now, support's back at 1237.90, resistance to 1260 level, and in the momentum, you are in an oversold condition. When I take a look at GLD, the popular ETF, it's identical to that of the futures contract. Oversold, higher high, lower low. Support in this case, the lower Bollinger Band, 117.14 and 119.17. The resistance, the 18-day average of closes. Let's look at GDX, the popular miners ETF. Look at the battleground. 18-day average of closes. This market stalled here, ran to the upper Bollinger Band, fell back, and just sort of sitting. It can go into a downtrend by just taking out today's low of 22.11 and closing lower tomorrow. You then have lower highs. You already got the lower low. So this market, while it was good, it may not be good very long. Now, here's something of interest. I moved now the gold-silver ratio to December because I can keep a D's gold versus a D's silver, so I don't have to take two different months of futures contracts, which you're stuck doing in many cases, not all the time, but in some. So if you go to the December, people that trade this ratio will look at that. This ratio still favors what? The higher it goes, gold is stronger than silver. The lower it goes, silver stronger than gold. Why? This is the amount of ounces you need to buy an ounce of gold. And the key to me is, where are you in relation to the 18-day average of closes, that filter? The upside bias is still to the upside. And if you look at, remember, this is a close only. You still have a pattern of higher lows, I think you'd agree, and higher highs. So I can call the thrust of the market up, the bias up too. When I look at silver itself, we should go back to yesterday, maybe the day before. Here's silver on Tuesday. Well, we know the bias is down because you're under the 18-day average. I'm sure I would have said higher high, lower low. There's no trend. You're in oversold territory. If you break down, maybe you go to the lower Bollinger Band. If you rally, resistance at the 18-day average of closes. Then yesterday, the market's breaking down, still oversold. Looking for support to see if it'll grab against the lower Bollinger Band. If it does, okay. If not, and you rally, resistance, the 18-day average. Today you break down, go to 1578, 1577.10. So you're about there. Market grabs hold and spins away from that 22 cents. You have not turned anything, but you've hit that area where you'd expect to see the support, and I'd expect to see resistance up in that 1619 area should the market rally there. Momentum is not giving us any idea of anything. It's just staying oversold. In the copper market, yesterday you hit the lower Bollinger Band. Back here you did too, and you'll notice as you're hitting it, you're spinning back above it, but you're not getting trend changes. To get a trend change, if momentum is going to lead price, the red line in the slow stochastic, it's called the K line, that should turn first over 20. The difference between the two K and D line, it's the same formula. I use 3 days of action on the K line, 5 days on the D line. So the K spins around like a moving average over the D, and it gives me an idea of the momentum. If you need to know more, go to Investopedia, anything like that. It'll tell you what the formulas are. Lower highs, lower lows, still a bear chart. Got a bounce, and that's all that I could say. In the slow stochastics on the palladium market, the market's got first a pattern of a higher high and lower low. Momentum is flat there. The bias is down. I don't have any idea what to call that type of chart. In the palladium market, you have a pattern of a higher high and a lower low. And again, the market rallied back to the 18-day average and stopped. Now, if momentum is leading price here, and that momentum has turned up, then this market should try to rally. If it does, where do you think the resistance might come in? I would be guessing, it's a great word for it, the 100-day average and the Bollinger Band are together in this 966 level, so that combination is all that I'd be looking for. Should the market take out yesterday's low of 926.20, I then would be looking for the 919 level to come back into play. Last, the dollar index. As we said, we got down to the Bollinger Band, and this was on Monday. Friday, you got just about there. You hit, in fact, you hit it, 957.50 to 958.10. So I'd expect to see some short covering. The market stalled out there again on Monday, started back up on Tuesday, got to the 18-day average, and it's sort of hanging here. So let's assume it can go higher. Then I'm looking for the Bollinger Band. Let's assume it wants to pull back and stay in a downtrend in terms of lower highs, lower lows. Then it should not take out 94.88.50. If you see 94.88.50 taken out, the odds favor you're just going to be spinning back and forth in here for a bit. That's what I'd be looking at. One of the ways you can get an edge on some of this is intraday, you look at a study called pivot points. And what they are, it's a popular trading tool to give you an idea when a market's up to a sell numbers or buy numbers. It's a mathematical formula. You don't think about it. The formula is very simple. We teach the formula. We have three videos. One is going to teach you the formula, how you do it. The second's going to tell you how to apply the study on most chart services that have it. And it will come out looking something like this. You'll have your neutral number, the white dash, depending on the colors you want to put on it. You'll have what's called the first support, S1, S2, resistance 1, resistance 2. Then what I do is I'll take you another step and I'll help you with slow stochastic so you put momentum with the numbers to get an idea that, gee, I'm looking to come out of a position or I'm thinking the market's overdone, I want into a position, whatever it might be. Sometimes you get an edge by using the slow stochastics with it. Three-part video, all free. How you get it is you give us a call, 866-973-2077. You can sign up at our website, www.irapstein.com, or you can always click up here right where I'm pointing and away you go. Either way, I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I'll see you all tomorrow.